You've just had your solar installed and it's time to start generating your own renewable electricity. Or is it? So assuming this is the first solar system that has been installed at your current address, you still need your retailer to update your meter so you get paid that solar feed-in tariff. But while you wait, did your installer leave your solar system on or did they turn it off? If they left it off for no good reason, it'll be costing you money, so why not turn it on? But it goes both ways. If they left it on and it should be turned off, it'll also be costing you money. So in Queensland, the decision comes down to the type of electricity meter that you have. And in this video, I'll show you the four types of electricity meters that will have wildly inaccurate readings if your solar is left turned on. And I'll reveal the two types of meters that are totally fine with solar from day one. I'm Mark from MC Electrical in Brisbane, and this is part of my Know Your Solar series, designed to help answer the most common questions that we get from customers after their solar is installed. But before we get started, I want to point out that this video is for Queenslanders. The rules are different in different states. And this video does not apply to you if you've just replaced an existing solar system. If that's the case, your electricity meter will already be programmed for solar, so you can just leave your solar turned on. Okay, let's get into it. The first meter that will cause issues if we leave your solar on is any spinning disc type of meter. If you leave your solar on, your meter will spin backwards every time you send surplus power back to the grid. And you'll be thinking to yourself, well, that's great. I'll save even more money if my solar spins my meter backwards. Well, it might save you more if we leave it on, but we're probably breaking the Queensland Electricity Act of 1994, which says it's an offence to interfere with any electricity meter. So that's why we leave it turned off. But you might be thinking to yourself, screw those rules from 1994. They obviously were not written with solar in mind and nobody will ever know. So you turn your solar on as we pull out of your driveway. Well, then you're a naughty little boy or girl, aren't you? But if you don't really care for my opinion, there's a second issue that you'll want to consider. Okay, let's say your meter reading before you got your solar installed was 35537 kilowatt hours, like this meter. And let's say over the next few months, you use some power and you send some power back to the grid. So your meter reading goes backwards and forwards a bit and backwards and forwards. And when the meter reader comes the next time, it turns out that you wound your meter back just a little bit to 35526, which is 11 kilowatt hours lower than your previous meter reading. So what will happen? Well, the meter reader will know that you've been a naughty little consumer and they will likely estimate your power bill. If your power bill was an average of $1,000 a quarter, let's say, then they'll probably just charge you that. And you won't want to argue the estimate because you have allegedly and potentially just been a naughty customer according to the 1994 Electricity Act. So obviously you could just turn your solar off for a few days to ensure that your meter does not wind back too far, but I am not recommending that. So just be patient and wait a few weeks or a few months for the good guys at the energy company to get their act together and change your meter before you turn on your solar system. Okay, the next three electricity meters have a different issue. So the Ampy Email type A11L and the Iskra type ME160 and the earlier models of the LG Email type EM1200. So these three meters were designed before solar was a thing. So apparently stealing electricity was the only way you could reduce your power bill. So one way to steal electricity was to trick the meter into winding backwards. So to combat these herb-growing electricity thieves, meters were programmed to measure the power going in reverse as being actually consumed. So these dopey electricity thieves were charged either way. So if you have one of these meters, you probably won't want to turn it on as we pull out of the driveway. So with these meters, the solar power that you consume, it's still free, but you'll get charged for all that power that you send back to the grid. Okay, for example, let's say in 3 months your solar produces 4,100 kilowatt hours, and let's say you only use 2,000 kilowatt hours of that power. So that would be worth about $400 of savings. So the remaining 2,100 kilowatt hours will be fed back into the grid. But instead of getting paid for that power, these old meters will charge you for it. And so in this case, the remaining 2,100 kilowatt hours will cost you around about $420. So in this case, leaving your solar on with one of these old type of meters will end up costing you about $20. And to add insult to injury, you would have been a naughty boy or girl because you've just contravened the Electricity Act from last millennium. Before we talk about the next two meters, give me a thumbs up if this has helped you understand why we may have left your solar turned off. Okay, now let's get on to the good news. If you have one of these Type 4 meters, you can turn your solar on from day one. So a Type 4 meter is pretty new. They've been mandatory since December 2017, whenever a new meter is installed. So you can identify them normally because they won't have ergon or Energex badge inside the meter. And additionally, you'll often notice this external antenna attached to the meter so that it can be read and programmed remotely. Type 4 meters are designed for solar. So leave your solar on and your retailer will remotely reprogram it for the solar feed-in tariff if they haven't already done so. And the last type of meter is any other type of digital meter not mentioned so far. You'll have to wait for this meter to be replaced or reprogrammed for solar. But in the meantime, leave your solar turned on. The solar that you produce and use will be free power effectively, but your meter won't register the surplus power that you send back into the grid. So you'll miss out on that feed-in tariff for a few months. So speaking of the feed-in tariff, did you really know how the feed-in tariff works? If not, check out this video that will pop up in a second. I'm Mark from MC Electrical in Brisbane, and I'll catch you on the next one.